Rumble in Rock'em City, a rock and roll adventure by the Brian Waite Band. Rock'em City, a metropolis of superheroes and supervillains. At any given moment, you might see a giant green man catching a falling train, or a caped Avenger saving the day. You might also catch a glimpse of a certain band of rock and roll adventurers, the Brian Waite Band. This day, the band has decided to take a break from their busy schedule and go to the carnival that has come to town. Meanwhile, back at their studio, three uninvited guests are creeping up to the door.
Are we there yet?
Yeah, are we there are yet? Shh!
Yeah, we're here. The Brian Waite Band studio, there on the right.
I don't see
you. No, the other right. Now, prepare to attack. Get ready. One, two, three. Hey. Listen up, Brian Waite Band. I'm in charge here.
Hey, where are they?
No one's home. I detect zero body heat signatures.
Drat, you're right, Monsieur Roboto. We missed them. I must have their music. I must have all the music, and with my ingenious music-stealing vacuum cleaner or moose vac, I will.
Yeah.
With this invention, I, Dr. Feelbad, will steal all of the songs of every band on the planet and in the universe. No one can stop me.
Hey, look, boss, a flyer to the Brian Waite Band's next show. It's tonight at the Velvet Underground Club.
Excellent work, Ziggy Stardust Mite.
It's Ziggy Star Dust Mite.
Whatever.
According to my search engine, there are three tickets left.
That's perfect. Deadbeat Gang, what do you say we crash the party and steal the show?
'Cause we're the bad guys. The bad guys. The bad guys. We're bad.
The shadows of a tall man in a zoot suit and hat, a bulky metal robot wearing a beret, and a mutant dust mite slink down the alley and out of sight. Just then, the bandmobile drives up and out steps the Brian Waite Band. They have returned from a great day at the carnival.
Wow, that was fun at the carnival.
Yeah, man, those funnel cakes were delicious.
Well, let's see what's happening in the world, shall we, gentlemen?
Okay.
Clip, stop fidgeting so we can hear, okay?
Oh, sorry.
We interrupt this broadcast with an urgent alert. According to the Daily Hero, the Deadbeat Gang is back in Rock'em City. Dr. Feelbad and his henchmen are stealing music. If you see them, do not approach. Call the authorities. They are extremely dangerous and annoying.
Man, I'm tired of all this bad news. Here, let me
Wait,
don't touch the radio!
Oh, sorry. Sorry, guys.
Remember, you can't touch electronics.
I know. If I touch anything electronic, it goes haywire. I don't know why, but I sure don't like it.
Hey, Todd, it's okay.
Yeah, no worries, man. It can be fixed. But guys, did you hear the radio? There's some kind of gang on the loose stealing music. Should we cancel our show at the Velvet Underground Club?
Oh, man. Nah, we'll be fine.
Okay. Yeah, you're right. I'm just worrying for nothing.
Hey, look at the time. We gotta go.
But look out the window, guys. There's a huge crowd of fans out there. Whoa. How are we gonna get by them?
Hey, I got an idea.
Todd pulls out three superhero suits complete with masks, gloves, and capes. His idea is to blend in with the Rock'em City citizens by dressing as superheroes, slip past the crowd, and head to the gig. Minutes later, no one notices them as they hurry by, capes flapping into the Rock'em City night.
It's a superhero, saving the day. Superhero, in the most amazing way. Superhero, fight.
fighting crime. Superhero, just in the nick of time.
As the bandmates search for the Velvet Underground Club, they marvel at the sights of Rock'em City.
Wow, did you guys see Supergirl fly by? I think it was her.
Yeah, I wish we had superpowers.
Yeah.
Achoo!
Kazoon tight.
Good for nothing allergies. I hate them.
Hey, don't beat yourself up, man. You may have allergies, but you have a lot of good things going for you, too. Like,
Hey, guys, there's the Velvet Underground.
Oh, thank goodness.
Looks like it's hopping.
Right on. This is going to be fun.
Yeah. Woo-hoo. Yeah. Hey, look, I'm a superhero.
The bandmates pretend to be superheroes and fly across the street into the packed club. Moments later, the club's DJ introduces them as they moonwalk onto the stage.
The party's bouncing in from the street. Bodies naked, controlled by the beat. Squeeze on in and bust up, fresh move. Raise the roof, raise the roof. Arms are up and pumping the sky. The crowd is rocking from side to side. Your grill is smiling, a shiny gold tooth. Raise the roof, raise the roof. Sing hey, ho. Hey, ho. Get hip to the sound. Everybody dance around at the Velvet Underground Club.
With the crowd cheering, it's time for Todd's big drum solo. Cliff and Brian head backstage to their dressing room to nibble on their bowl full of blue M&Ms. Meanwhile, the deadbeat gang lurk in the shadows at the back of the club.
Dr. Feelbad, the drummer Todd is all alone. This would be an excellent time to steal his music.
But wait a minute! He looks like a superhero, boss! Maybe we shouldn't tangle with him! Let's rethink this!
No! Listen to Ziggy Roboto. He's all scared. Don't make me laugh. That's just a costume!
Someday when I get my stockbroker's license, I'll get out of this racket.
What?
Nothing! Nothing!
All right, deadbeat gang. It's time to make our move.
The deadbeat gang leap from the shadows and onto the stage.
Got you now, there's no place to go. You can't save the day, you're no hero. We're gonna take what we want, anytime we please. We're gonna do what we want, cause we're police.
Ziggy, grab him while I steal all his music with the moves back.
Get off of me! Hey! Ow! That hurts!
Ah! He threw me off, boss! I'm no match for him!
I can't count on you for nothing, Dustmite. Roboto, you get him!
As the scared and confused crowd runs for the exits, Monsieur Roboto lunges at Todd.
You will give us all the music?
No, I won't!
Hey, watch out for his drumsticks!
Yes, you will.
No, I won't!
Roboto, don't be a chicken like Ziggy. Use your robo-clamps!
Yes, boss. I will use my robo-clamps to hold him.
Monsieur Roboto bears down on Todd. Todd reaches out to block the attack. His arm brushes against the robot's control panel and suddenly... zapping is heard and smoke swirls out of Roboto's beret.
Oh no, not again. I didn't mean to break you, Mr. Robot.
As usual, Todd has broken something electronic. But this time it was a good thing. His touch has rebooted Monsieur Roboto and caused the robot's evil programming to be lost. Roboto has been restored to his original, friendly, helpful self.
You have 27 updates. Your printer is low on ink. What? I'm back. Merci for fixing me, Todd. Au revoir.
You're welcome. See ya.
What? Come back here, Roboto.
No.
Todd, what have you done to Roboto? You got lucky this time, but I did get some of your music with my Moosevac. We'll meet again and I'll finish the job.
So what now, boss? I suppose we go back to our secret lair located beneath the roller coaster.
Stop! Don't tell him that, you numbskull!
Tell him what?
That our secret lair is located beneath the roller coaster. Wait. We gotta get out of here before you open your big mouth again.
Hey, you're the one that said it the second time.
No, it was your fault, you numbskull.
No, you started it.
How are we ever gonna get this figured out if we're...
You never should have asked me that stupid question.
Dr. Feelbad and Ziggy Stardust Might.
That's Ziggy Stardust Might.
Whatever. The remaining deadbeat gang turn and run out the back door. Cliff and Brian come back on stage expecting Todd to be finishing his drum solo. Instead, they find the club empty, except for a shaken Todd who tells them what happened.
Todd, you disabled a robot guy? Sweet!
Your ability to make electronics go haywire helped you.
Yeah, you know, I guess you're right. That makes me feel really good. But they stole some of my music.
Man, somebody's got to stop those guys.
Yeah, and get your music back.
What should we do?
Let's call a superhero.
Yeah!
You've reached Happy Girl. I'm stretched too thin and not taking any new cases.
Man, let's try another one.
Thank you for calling Rope Man. I'm tied up at the moment. Please leave a message.
Man, we're really striking out here.
On, one more try.
Come on.
This is Alligator Man, and I'm swamped. I bit off more than I can chew, but your call is very important.
Darn, looks like all the superheroes are busy.
Looks that way. I guess if we're going to get your music back, Todd, it's up to us.
I don't know. That could be dangerous.
No. We can do this, guys. Look, I disabled one of them and chased off the other two.
Right.
True. Yes. Yeah. We got this. Where did they go?
Hey, the Dust Mite guy said something about a secret lair located underneath a roller coaster.
The roller coaster? I bet it's the one at the carnival.
Yeah.
Let's go get him.
Yeah, let's go.
But guys, I'm really allergic to dust mites. Wait.
Hey, everybody, won't you come with me? We're going to the carnival. We got lots of good rides and a yummy candy down at the carnival. I bet you're gonna find that the fun keeps coming down at the carnival. We'll all go together, be in the sunny weather down at the carnival.
When the band arrives at the carnival, Cliff and Todd go to get elephant ears while Brian holds their spot in the line for the roller coaster. Meanwhile, inside their evil lair, Ziggy watches for intruders on the monitor.
Uh-oh, Dr. Feelbad, it looks like the Brian Waite Band's here. I can see on the monitor that Brian's in the roller coaster line by himself.
What? Ziggy, see what you've done?
You've led
them right to us.
Oh, brother, here we go.
Never mind. This could work to our advantage, Ziggy. Hand me the moose vac.
As Brian waits in line, Dr. Feelbad and Ziggy creep up behind him.
We've got you now. Ziggy, grab him.
Ziggy jumps and wraps his dusty legs around Brian. Dr. Feelbad turns on the moose vac and starts sucking music out of him. As the dust from Ziggy's legs wafts around Brian, his allergies kick into overdrive. His eyes begin to water. His nose starts to twitch. A huge monster sneeze, a super sneeze, erupts from Brian. The full blast hits Ziggy Stardust Mite and launches him into the sky.
What? How did you do that?
Excuse me.
You may have beat my henchman Brian, but you'll never get me or your music back.
Dr. Feelbad runs off. Just then, Todd and Cliff come back with their elephant ears.
Hey, what's going on here?
I just got attacked by the deadbeat gang, but I blew the dust mite guy away with a huge sneeze.
Whoa, that's awesome. Your allergies saved the day.
Yeah, see, Brian, I told you not to beat yourself up about your allergies. Turns out you do have something good going for you.
Yeah, way to go, man.
Thanks, guys. But Dr. Feelbad got away with some of my music.
Hey, there he is, jumping on the roller coaster.
Let's go!
Riding on a coaster, 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 riding on a mountain of steel. Put your hands up high as the world flies by. Ain't no better way to feel.
Uh-oh!
What?
There's a huge drop-off up ahead.
Oh, no!
Hold on!
Yeah, we're coming to the free fall, and we're gathering speed. Belly's quaking, this roller coaster's really neat.
There he goes! His car is swerving into that dark tunnel.
Lean hard to the left and we'll follow him.
The bandmate's car enters the tunnel, but instead of coming out the other side, their car starts to slow down. Little do they know, Dr. Feelbad has lured them into a trap.
It's pitch black in here, guys.
I can't see anything.
Hey, why is our car stopping?
Because I've got you in my trap! Right where I want ya.
Chains are suddenly thrown around the bandmates and locked tight.
Get off of me!
All right, boys. It's time to say goodbye to all your music. It's all mine, mine, mine! And now, say hello to the moves, Vac!
No, stop that!
You could never beat me! I've got your music and you're locked up in chains. Now I can finish stealing all the music in the world! So long, boys! Enjoy your long stay in my lair!
The victorious Dr. Feelbad leaves the bandmates chained and alone in the dark dungeon. Cliff starts fidgeting again, and Brian and Todd hang their heads as they realize their situation is hopeless.
Oh man, we've lost all of our music. What are we gonna do?
I don't know. There's no way we'll ever get out of these chains, guys. I hate to say this, but we've been defeated. And Cliff, will you stop that infernal fidgeting?
Hey, I'm sorry. I just can't help myself.
Wait a minute. That sounds like music. Cliff, do you see what's happening here?
Yeah. Dr. Feelbad may have stolen our music, but we can always create more.
That's right.
Right.
Boom, 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 boom.
I wanna get boom, boom, free.
Boom, 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 boom.
I wanna get boom,
boom, boom,
out.
Boom, boom, boom.
I wanna boom, get on boom, the boom, upbeat.
Boom, 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 boom.
So we can boom, sing and boom, shout.
As the band's new song gains steam, Cliff's fidgeting grows into finger snaps and toe taps. He starts dancing wildly. Suddenly, the chains start to fly off of the bandmates.
Yeah, the chains are coming off.
I wanna get free.
Cliff, you did it! Your fidgeting busted the chains!
We're free! You saved us all, man!
You're right! My fidgeting turned out to be a good thing!
Drawn back by all of the commotion, Dr. Feelbad bursts into the room holding the moose back.
What's all this racket, huh? And why aren't you in your chains?
We busted out of those chains of yours when we made music.
What? But how did you do that? I took your music.
We discovered something you never realized. You can't take our music. We can just make more. It's inside each one of us.
Really? Ah, then this moose vac here is worthless. No wonder it was on sale.
Dr. Feelbad throws the moose vac on the ground.
Nuts! All I wanted was music. It's so beautiful. I just wanted it all for myself. And I would have got away with it if it hadn't been for you meddling superheroes.
And with that, Dr. Feelbad turns and runs away.
Superheroes?
I'm just a guy that fidgets a lot.
I have allergies, that's all.
Yeah, and every time I touch electronics, they break. I didn't think that was anything to be proud of.
But you know what, you guys? Those things that we didn't like about ourselves actually made us heroes.
Wow.
Yeah, that's really
cool. Hey, and if those things make us heroes, I bet everyone has something that could make them a hero, too.
The bandmates climb out of the lair and stand upon an outcrop. Keeps flapping in the wind. As they gaze across the Rock'em City skyline, they realize that they learned an important lesson. Don't feel bad about yourself. The things you like the least might turn out to be your biggest strengths. If you use those strengths for good, no matter what your story, you too can be a hero.
We're the heroes, save the day. We're the heroes of Rock'em City.